Coming up next on Campus News, we tell you about the Youth of the Month, we show you the 2019 LISD Spelling Bee, and we tell you what schools were nominated to be the National Blue Ribbon Campuses.
All this and much more coming up on Campus News, Laredo's best and only news for students. Hello, and thank you for joining LISD's very own Student Newscast, the only newscast that offers the most in school and community coverage for students. I'm Leanne Bernal.
And I'm John Paul from Nixon High School. Here's our top story. Over the past few years, a couple of our LISD schools have earned the distinction of being named Blue Ribbon Campuses. That is the Garcia Early College High School and the Kawas Elementary School. This year, four more of our LISD schools have been nominated for that great award. Those schools are Dovalina, J.C. Martin, Ryan, and Zachary Elementary Schools. Let's take a look at what our superintendent, Dr. Silvio Rios, and the principals of those schools had to say about these nominations.
It's a very great honor. We always set goals at the beginning of the school year. And when we set these goals, we always take into consideration, who are we serving? We are serving the children of this community. And we want to make sure that they have the opportunity to get the best education possible. So I am extremely proud of each of these four principals. I think that they have exemplified the standards to which LISD aspires. They also exemplify the standards of educators who care about their students. And they are models, not only for our school district, but also for any other school district in the state of Texas and in this community. I think that their hard work is really now evidenced in this nomination.
It was a great surprise when we received the nomination, the official nomination. We were very happy and ecstatic, and really it was a surreal feeling to have known that we were considered among the best campuses in the state and now nationally. Our students are ready to learn, and they're always here, early in the mornings, eating their breakfast in the classroom, excited about what's coming up next. And so our students are excited and proud that they've reached this level of success.
It is a great honor to be nominated. We understand it is only a nomination at this point, but we're excited and enthusiastic about the possibility of being recognized at the national level. We prescribe to the notion that learning rather than teaching is the fundamental purpose of our school, and we want to make sure that our students learn all the time. Students, for their part, they're always excited, enthusiastic about coming to school. They give us their best, and our community make this professional learning community the place to be.
I was in shock. You know, I couldn't believe that we finally had accomplished the Blue Ribbon nomination. You know, I've always seen it, you know, at different campuses, but I just couldn't believe that finally it arrived at Zachary Elementary. I have very, very hardworking teachers. You know, students always come first. We're always looking out to see how we can better instruction, how we can differentiate, what types of activities we can pick up, learn, and how we can use them in our classroom so that we can have our kids better prepared for the future.
It feels great that we're a 2019 Blue Ribbon nominee this year, and we're just ecstatic, and we're so very proud of our dedicated teachers. They're so committed to the teaching and learning of our students, and also we're thankful to our parents. We have a great parent involvement program, and our parents are all in for the education of their children.
We would also like to thank all of the parents, the community, as well as our Board of Trustees for creating a vision to which we all aspire, for supporting our schools, supporting our students and our staff, and then giving us the tools with which to make all dreams come true in our educational pathways.
Congratulations to the staff and students of those four schools for having been nominated to become National Blue Ribbon Schools. The most recent Youth of the Month ceremony was held for the month of January. This time it was held by Lyndon B. Johnson High School. The Youth of the Month ceremony is put together by United States Border Patrol and several other community sponsors. This event selects one student from each Laredo High School and honors them as the Youth of the Month. The students from LISD who were selected to receive this honor were Sylvia Martinez from Sigaroa, Cassandra Romero from the Garcia Early College High School, Valeria Guerrero from Nixon, and Valeria Brundera from Martin High School. Many parents and school staff were at this event to help congratulate the students for this achievement. The students had the opportunity to say thank you to each of those individuals for helping them over the years. Congratulations to all of these students for this wonderful achievement. Keep up the great work.
LISD recently held its 2019 Spelling Bee at the Vidal M. Trevino Magnet School. 24 students participated in this very exciting competition. The students practiced many long hours with their parents and coaches in preparation for the Spelling Bee. Veronica Castillon is the Director of Communications for LISD. She tells us more about this competition.
We have just concluded a fierce LISD Spelling Bee today. We went a historic 26 rounds of spelling, and in the end, our first place winner for the second year in a row is Ms. Mia Cuevas, who this year is a student at Lamar Middle School.
Mia Cuevas tells us how she feels about this great achievement.
It makes me very happy to know that that I actually made it, and I want to say thank you to all my coaches. Ever since elementary, they started me off, and I'm really happy to have been able to win this competition.
Gabriel Benavides from Santa Maria Elementary School came in second, and Luis Gonzalez of Ryan Elementary placed third in the Spelling Bee. All these students will now compete in the citywide Spelling Bee. This event will be held on Saturday, March 23rd at TAMIU. Congratulations to all these students for having competed in such an exciting LISD Spelling Bee. An important proclamation was recently held at the City Hall Chambers. This is for Earned Income Tax Credit Awareness Day in the city of Laredo. Members of LISD, UISD, and the Laredo Family Economic Success Coalition VITA program were present at this proclamation. The VITA program offers free tax preparation services through IRS-certified volunteers for low to moderate income families. Kayla Hernandez is a student at Sierra High School and is a volunteer at VITA. She has volunteered for 3 years, and this year she is a quality reviewer for VITA. Kayla tells us how it feels to be able to do something like this.
I think it's pretty cool for my age, personally, that I know how and what to do in a site like this. I think it's a really big responsibility, therefore, because it gives back to the community. And I think it's something small but big at the same time to do.
There are many locations across Laredo where you can receive this assistance from VITA, including Martin, Nixon, and Sierra High School. If you would like to know more information, you can contact VITA at 307-8138.
Another wonderful ceremony was held where great students were honored, but this time, it was to honor outstanding 8th graders from our city's middle schools. This time, the event was held at United South Middle School. A different law enforcement organization, the Laredo Police Department, puts this event together. Several community sponsors also contribute to the success of the event, like KGNS-TV and Family Nissan. The students from LISD who were selected for this great award were Isela Sanchez-Diaz from Sigaroa Middle, Alejandro Hernandez from Kristen, Kyle Hamlin from Lamar, and Valeria Sanchez from Memorial Middle School. Many of the students' parents were present at this event to show their support for their achievements. At the end of the event, everybody gathered to take a picture. LISD would like to thank these community organizations and the Laredo Police Department for selecting some of our great students to be honored in this great ceremony.
Another very interesting and educational mock trial was recently held over at the Webb County Court at Law No. 2. This time, high school students were invited and some of our LISD students attended this event. This is an ongoing series of mock trials that are being held for students in this courtroom, and it is called Access to Justice, Class in the Courtroom. Our Texas State Senator, Judith Staffarini, was present at this mock trial. She tells us about the purpose of these mock trials.
Basically, what they learn every time is more about the social justice system, access to justice, why we have courts, why we have laws, and the consequences of disobeying the laws, the importance of obeying the laws. Not only do they learn about trials and courtrooms and get to interact with a judge, but they also learn certain social justice lessons. For example, today, in the mock trial of Zorro, we concentrated on bullying.
Bilingualism is something that is very prominent in these mock trials. Senator Zaffarini tells us more about this.
We also use a lot of Spanish, and the students who don't speak Spanish know that the words will be translated either directly or in context. For example, in one of the mock trials, one of the characters said, "Ay te guacho cucaracho," and then he said, "That's like saying, see you later, alligator." So there's a lot to learn in these mock trials, and we have a lot of fun presenting them to the students. Our goal is to make them educational, but also entertaining.
Victor Villarreal is the judge of Webb County Court at Law No. 2. He believes it is critically important for people to learn about jury service. He tells us more about that.
It's absolutely critical to our system of justice that this generation, the next generation of future jurors, learn and they see the importance of their service. We want them to come back when they're summoned, and we want them to be excited about serving there as a juror and to perform their civic obligation, because we, in the United States, have one of the last systems of jury service, and this opens up the door and educates them as to the importance of jury service.
At the end of the mock trial, one of the judge's staff members, who was portraying a friend of Soro, sang his favorite song, Jalisco No Te Rajes. LISD would like to thank our State Senator Judith Zaffarini and Judge Victor Villarreal for allowing our students to participate in this very valuable mock trial. When we return, our co-anchors Raul and Daniela will continue with the news. Stay tuned.
Laredo ISD would like to remind you about the importance of driving safely around our school buses. Remember that all drivers must stop every time that a school bus turns on its red lights. Students may be entering or exiting the school bus, and it is our responsibility to make sure they get to their destination safely. At LISD, safety is our number one priority, so we would like to invite you to do your part and always drive safely around our school buses. Have you been studying and working hard to become a teacher? Laredo ISD would like to invite you to join a stable school district that has been around for more than 135 years. We offer competitive pay comparative to any school district across the state of Texas. New teachers will earn $47,250 at Laredo ISD.
You know, it's a fun environment here at LISD, and so far, it's amazing. The staff are very professional, very helpful. Since day one, I felt very welcome here at Cigarroa High School with LISD. The students are amazing. You know, they're quick learners. They're not afraid to actually, you know, join the conversation and listen in the lessons that we're giving.
We also offer great benefits like partially paid health and life insurance, 5 days state personal leave, and 5 days local sick leave every year you are employed, and a TRS retirement plan. Teachers can also receive stipends depending on your qualifications, like $800 for bilingual, $1,000 for ESL secondary, $2,500 for science, $2,500 for mathematics, $1,000 for special education resource, $4,000 for special education self-contained.
The pay, believe it or not, a little bit better than you get at some TV stations. I know a lot of people think that we get paid a lot of money to be on TV, but especially in the smaller markets, a city the size of Laredo, it's not always great. And here at Laredo ISD, you know, got a nice little pay raise and better time off. And so it was a fun and new challenging aspect to take in my life.
Teachers will also have many professional development opportunities and reimbursements for Texas exams and certification fee. Teachers also have a new teacher mentoring program available to them. Most of our 33 school campuses are new buildings, so you will have the opportunity to work in the latest state-of-the-art facilities. Plus, you will receive all the support you need to have a rewarding and lasting career as a teacher.
So I've worked at Laredo ISD for 5 years now, 2 years at non-traditional, and 3 years now at BMT, and I love it here. I don't think I'll ever leave. I think I'll probably retire here. It's an awesome district. Like I said, as a student, I love the atmosphere, and as a teacher, I love it too, and I don't see myself going anywhere else.
So if you are interested in becoming a teacher at LISD, we invite you to go to our website and apply now. You can also call 273-1000 for more information.
Welcome back to Campus News. I'm Raul Ramos.
And I'm Daniela Aguirre, and we will continue on with the news.
In January, many of our LISD schools took the time to say thank you to our School Board of Trustees. This was because January is known nationally as School Board Member Appreciation Month. Leon Dikes Elementary School was one of those schools who held an appreciation breakfast for the LISD board members. Lisa Soto is the principal at Dikes. She tells us why they organize this event for the school board members.
Today is a very special day as we welcome our board members to our school. We want to tell them how much we appreciate everything that they do for us. We thank them for planting the seeds of success. And so we have a little breakfast for them this morning just to show how grateful we are for everything they do for us.
During the event, the board members were able to see a video where the students and staff members of the school thanked them. At the end, everybody gathered to take a picture. Over 300 of our fellow LISD students were recently invited to the movies at Cinemark Mall del Norte. This was thanks to the generosity of Judge Becky Palomo and the 341st District Court. Judge Palomo was there at the movies on this day. She tells us about this event.
We're very excited that this week we've been able to bring over 1,000 students to watch the movie On the Basis of Sex, which is a feature film that is about Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg. And it features her life starting as a first-year law student and the challenges and struggles that she was able to overcome. And ultimately, being able to change certain laws that discriminated against both men and women.
She also shares with us what she would like the students to take away from this experience.
I want these young ladies to know that I get to wear this robe today because of people like Justice Ginsburg, who was passionate and dedicated and committed and fought to change the laws that prevented women from being in leadership positions and being in positions of judgeships like me today.
The students really enjoyed this opportunity. LASD would like to thank Judge Becky Palomo for providing the experience for our students.
Parents recently attended a very important class at McDonald Elementary School. This class was offered through LISD's Parent and Family Engagement Program. The title of this class is No Tengo Dinero Para Malgastar, which translates to I Don't Have Money to Waste. Carlos René Ramírez is the lead parental liaison for LISD. He gives these classes to the parents of our school district. He shares with us what this class is about.
In the first class, they were able to have a wonderful opportunity to learn from some financial advisors what would be the best option for them. And it's offered to them to where you can even have on a one-to-one basis to look into their details when it comes to the finances at home. So today, part two of this course, which is the second class, will give us the opportunity to always be aware of our needs. When it comes on savings, the importance of that and how to put it into practice.
Parents really enjoyed coming to this very valuable class. If you're interested in participating in one of these classes, please contact the parent liaison at your school. A very important recruitment event was recently held over at Memorial Middle School. This event was held so our LISD early college high schools and magnet schools could recruit students to sign up for their programs. This event was for the 8th graders of our school district. Rogelio Garcia is the Director for College, Career, and Military Readiness for the LISD. He tells us more about this event.
We are here at Memorial Middle School for our Magnet School Early College Recruitment Event. We have 8th graders from across the district, and what we're doing right now is we're going to present all the early college, high schools, and magnet school opportunities that these students can have now that they're venturing off into 9th grade freshmen. They're going to choose an endorsement. They can get to pick a pathway. So we're talking about engineering, health science, accounting, welding. We have all these wonderful early college high schools opportunities and magnets for our students here at LISD.
Students were able to listen and view some very impressive presentations. Then they walked up to the booths where they signed up for the programs that most interested them. This was a great recruitment event that was held over at Memorial Middle School.
A special presentation was recently held over at Caguas Elementary, a national blue ribbon school. The city of Laredo was at the school to present Caguas Elementary the key to the city. This key to the city was presented by council member Vidal Rodriguez, who was once a student at Caguas Elementary School. Vanessa Ortegon is the principal at Caguas Elementary. She tells us more about this special award.
Today we will be receiving an award from the city because of our status of Blue Ribbon. This is such a great honor to receive the key to the city because we're the first in history to do that. And it's just been an amazing journey, you know, becoming a Blue Ribbon school receiving the key from the county, and now we'll be receiving the key to the city. We're so proud of our students and our staff for this amazing award.
Our school board member for District 7, Monica Garcia, was present at this event. She spoke to everybody in attendance, and she told them that she was very proud of all the great work that is being done at Gawas Elementary School. We would like to once again congratulate Gawas Elementary for having been named a National Blue Ribbon School.
Another one of our great elementary schools also held a special event for our school board members. Ryan Elementary invited our school board of trustees to their school so they could enjoy a delicious breakfast. Elsa Flores is the principal of Ryan Elementary. She tells us about this event.
It is Board Recognition Month, and in the month of January, we celebrate all of our board members for everything they do for our students, our campuses, and our district.
Ryan Elementary is one of the four LIC schools that has been nominated to become a Blue Ribbon campus this year. The leadership that is provided by our board members is an integral part in that success, so the staff at Ryan Elementary was very happy that the board members joined them for breakfast so they could say thank you for everything they do for the students at LISD. That wraps up this edition of Campus News. I'm Daniela Aguirre.
And I'm Raul Ramos. Don't forget to tune in next time. Until then, make sure you continue to do your part so we can continue building tomorrow together. See you next time.
Bacteria. Here's how. Dab your sneeze or your cough. Wash or sanitize your hands often. Get your flu shot. Talk to your school nurse about flu clinics at your school. Stay healthy and be in school. Remember, every day counts.
Thank you.
How are you?
Good.
I don't know, it's really hot outside and really tired. I don't know, I just...
¿Sabes qué hacer si alguien de repente se está colapsando? Laredo ISD siente que es importante que sepas estos pasos que pueden ayudar a salvar la vida de alguien. Primer paso, asegúrate de que la escena sea segura y checa si la persona está respondiendo. Segundo paso, llama al 911 o dile a alguien que llame al 911 y que consiga un defibrilador automatizado si está disponible. Tercer paso, empieza las compresiones. Presiona fuerte y rápido en el centro del pecho a una velocidad de 100 latidos por minuto. Si es muy difícil para ti, recuerda que es equivalente a la canción de Staying Alive. Recuerda, son solo tres pasos. Checa si la persona está respondiendo, llama al 911 y no pares las compresiones hasta que el servicio de emergencia médica llegue.
I can be a nurse.
I can be a police officer.
I can be an artist.
I could be a professional basketball player.
I can be a doctor.
As we continue to excel in this 2018-2019 school year, LISD reminds you of the importance of daily attendance. Attending school every day is the first step towards having success with your education. Make sure that you arrive to your campus on time and ready to learn. Your teachers are planning fun and interesting lessons for you, but make sure that you do your part by attending school every day. Daily school attendance, it will make you a successful student.